Hey guys, Boecraft here, and welcome back to another Minecraft video. Today I'm going to start a new series called the Underwater Survival Challenge. Not many people are aware of this challenge, but they are aware of another challenge that is very similar to it, or at least those who played beta Minecraft, which was the 404 challenge, where basically that was you spend your first day on the surface collecting like all the resources you possibly could, And basically, you went to a gravel beach, dug out a bit of gravel, and it would open up this massive cave system. You had to spend, like, the rest of your life down there. Well, the underwater challenge is really similar to that. Just instead of going into a cave system, it's underwater, hence the name Underwater Survival Challenge. But you can do this with any seed, any world, basically. So, it's a lot of fun. I miss the 404 challenge. I actually did it. I guess you could say I did it, but I did it on peaceful, so that makes me a cheapskate. So, let's do this. But my vanilla normal survival VNS series will still go on, just I'm getting pretty bored filming because the other day I filmed like 3 or 4 episodes in one day, so I got really bored. Aha! Nice. Right next to an ocean biome. Perfect. Okay. So right now, time is of the essence. One thing right now is probably important, which is to gather up seeds, because I ain't going to get any of those anytime soon, and trees, especially saplings. If I cannot get saplings whatsoever, I got a big problem. So, I'm going to, like, get down as many of these guys as I possibly can. So basically, I can only spend this one day. Once when the sun sets, I have to go underwater. And that is that. No more daylight for me. So. Hopefully this will be fun for me. Hopefully I don't die. I guess I could do... I might want to do the rules where if I... If I die, I die and that's it. I might do that. I might not. Depends if I... what I'm thinking when I die. And for some odd reason, whoa, that was really weird. And my inventory bar is like completely spazzing out for some odd reason, I don't know why. I really need these sheeps for bedding, which... come here, sheep! Whoa, my voice just did something really weird there. Okay, let's get out these guys. It's kind of hard to figure out what you should and should not do. Excellent, another sapling. That's a chasm. Oh, yeah. Okay, come. Why are you sheeps being so stupid? Get back here. Get back here, sheep. No. Where'd that sheep go? There he is. There's the little guy. Yay. Okay, so I got 3 of those guys. That's really useful. So then I can have a bed and reset my spawn point down there. Okay, hang on. Okay, there we go. Excellent. I don't know why my inventory is glitching out, probably because I have auto switch mod. I'm not sure if it's on or off right now. So, yeah, if you had really weird lag spikes, that was probably me hitting the key that activates and deactivates it, so. I noticed the frame rate dropped pretty bad. Down to like 3 or even 4 frames a second. So. Alright, probably one of the main things I should make would be ladders, so then I can have a nice stable environment for me to make my base. So let's get crack-a-lackin' on that. There we go. I'll probably need all those. Alrighty. That was pretty stupid of me. Alright, there we go. Perfect. There we go. Actually, it wouldn't be quite a bad idea to dig up some of this dirt, too. Just so I can create my own little air pocket. Where is the sun? There it is. Not even noon. Excellent. Yeah, sorry if this is really boring of me just punching down trees, but I kind of need them all. Or I could be a complete idiot moron man and just go straight underwater right now. Could get some sand for glass. That would look pretty nice. Even though I could get some underwater, but oh well. With challenges like these, anything you can get your hands on will be really useful. Just the unfortunate thing is, I really don't have a bucket so I can get water, but I guess I could have an open access for my farm. It's actually not a bad idea. Okay. So. Okay. Wow, 42 sand, that's a lot. Okay, so I guess, how much junk do I have? Not optimal, but actually I could go for that bare stone thing so I can make some charcoal underwater for torches. Or if there's coal over there, that would save me wood. A lot of wood. Even though I can easily get stone down there, but... oh well, it's good to be prepared. Oh shoot, food. In the meantime of crops. Guess I'll have to risk my life and kill some of these chickens. Come back here, chicken! There we go. But wait, there's more chickens. You shall win a free ticket to death. Okay, any coal here? Please tell me there's some form of coal. I feel like I'm rushing right now. Pop. Bam. Okay, that should be good for now. Ah, come on. We're being more chickens. There's one. Excellent. Oh yay, two more. Even more of an excellent. Dead before he hit the ground. No! I must get wet before I have to. Oh gosh. Ocean biomes are deep, aren't they? I guess now it's time to venture underwater. Ooh! Squids! There being a lot of squids down there. Okay, I guess I'll head right up to the shoreline, because I can. And I can... okay, there we go. Now I got a nice little stable air pocket that I can work with. I guess I can end the episode here. I've gotten a lot of progress done. I gathered up probably enough resources for me to live with. So this has been Boecraft. And I'm in an air pocket underwater. And I bid you all farewell on your life's journeys and adventures. Thank you for watching. Gerbil, 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 I'm drowning.